Thank you, everyone, and good afternoon, and welcome to Queensborough's Celebration of Service. Before we begin, I invite you to join me in a moment of silence to honor the victims of the tragic shooting in Buffalo. Thank you. Today we've gathered to mark a special occasion, an occasion that marks two firsts. It is the first time in over 3 years that we've been able to come together as a community to celebrate the service of our colleagues formally and officially. And it is the first time I've had the honor to be a part of this wonderful tradition that has been celebrated for more than 50 years. We're here on this beautiful day to pay tribute to you, our honorees who have reached 20, 30, 40, and yes, even 50 years of distinguished service. Speaking of this, I would like to acknowledge our 50-year honoree, Dr. Archie Calise, Senior Director of Institutional Research. Archie, if you can please stand to be recognized. Indeed, many have been here have spent the better part of their lives committed to making a difference in the lives of our students. So whether you work with students in a classroom, you interact with students as they register for classes and seek financial and other support, work behind the scenes processing bills, filing paperwork, and keeping official records, or maintain a safe, clean, and an exceptionally beautiful campus, today is about you. Each of you make it possible for Queensborough to provide an inclusive, equitable, and an exceptional student experience that allows our community of learners to grow, thrive, and succeed. We will now commence with our individual award presentations. Dr. Pecorino, Chair of the Faculty Executive Committee, will assist in recognizing this afternoon's honorees, beginning with those inducted into the 20-year association. We will begin with Nesta Arboleda, if you can please come up.
Hey. Thank you so much. Charlie, you're the one who opened the door for me. Thank you so much, Charlie. John Louie, guys, and all my friends in the campus, thank you.
Don't go anywhere. We're gonna come take a picture. Dr. Wilma Fletcher Anthony.
Hi everyone, what a lovely day to be able to see everyone and have a celebration. So I'd just like to thank everyone who has been with me on this journey, who motivated, encouraged, and supported all along this time. Thank you all so much.
Dr. Peter Bales.
I'm certainly going to take the full 1 minute. Queensborough has always been right for me from the beginning. And I want to make a couple of quick points. I have mellowed in my 22 years here. Because recently in a class essay, a student wrote in my American Government and Politics class that the mayor of New York City the mayor of New York City is Adam Sandler. And I gave partial credit for that. You also have to have a sense of humor to survive at Queensborough. Recently, I was getting very passionate in my class, and I told the students that I'm old enough to remember where I was when I heard that JFK had been assassinated. And I'm also, of course, old enough to remember, and some of you do, when I heard about 9/11. And a student in the back row yelled out, "Hey, Dr. Bales, where were you when the Titanic went down?" And I said I was in the water freezing with Leonardo DiCaprio because Kate Winslet would not let us up on the platform and there was plenty of room. And then we debated that for 10 minutes. But I've had a wonderful 22 years. I'll just say it again. It's been right for me from day one. I started on the same day President Marti did, and I met him in medical arts, and I said, "I'm new, I'm lost." And he said, "I'm the president of the college, and I'm lost too." Thank you so much.
There is a biology professor said to me once, and she said, "Cheyenne, you are a baby at Queensborough." And today I'm here, I have to say, yes, I'm a baby here, and compared with all of you, 30, 40, 50 years, yes, but I'm still here, I'm not leaving yet. I will make 30, 40, 50, something.
So, small point of trivia. This is my first time ever on a pergola. But this is very nice. I want to thank you. I don't have a whole speech, but it's nice to be acknowledged for hard work. And my years at Queensborough have been very satisfying and very hard work. I was 6 foot tall when we started back in 2000. So, but seriously, I grew up not far from here in Queens Village, and when I was doing all my years of being an adjunct at 7 different colleges, I always hoped I'd land here because it was always my favorite place, and I'm glad I did. Thank you.
Wow, almost 23 years working in QCC. When I first time came here, I was a young mom. Now I'm a grandma. As many of you know, I filed my retirement. I think I'm the youngest one to retire from Queensborough. But I love this place. This is a wonderful place to work. I have a very happy time here. With a Asian Culture Festival every year, I love to perform. And then the Chinese Academy, I started 17 years ago. So it's a lot of happy memory here. And then I gained so many friendships here. Thank you for everyone. Thank you for supporting me. And I will continue support QCC. Yeah! This is Shirley Chan style.
Georgina Kulalilo. No pressure to follow that. Congratulations.
Wow. It does not feel like 21 years. I guess it's because I enjoyed every moment of it and will continue to enjoy it. I want to thank all my mentors from the different departments, and nursing department, of course, also, and the folks at grants and sponsored programs for supporting me and never saying no to any of my ideas. I enjoyed every moment of it. When I came here 21 years ago, I was amazed at the talent of the faculty, the longevity of the faculty and staff, and the dedication to students. And I hope we can continue to doing this good work. Thank you so much.
Dr. Beth Ann Cunahan.
Thank you very much. It's been such a privilege to teach here. Our wonderful students, our beautiful campus, wonderful colleagues. It's just lovely. So thank you very much.
Dr. Victor Vicharo.
Wow, I don't think I've ever said anything in less than 1 minute. It's gonna be a little tough. I'd just like to say I'm grateful. We're all here today on this wonderful day. I'm grateful that I had the opportunity to work here back 20 years ago when Archie gave me a call for interviewing for the testing office. I'm grateful that I get to work in this city within a city, a sort of microcosm, with people from so many different areas and fields and areas of expertise where I've had an opportunity to learn. Because after all, that's what this is all about. It's all about learning. Thank you.
Mark Howell.
I would like to say thank you.
Marilyn Katz.
So,
21 years ago, with much trepidation, I left a corporate job that I loved to come to Queensborough with the promise of good benefits and summers off. In return, I was rewarded with a career that has been fulfilling both intellectually and socially. I discovered students who are, for the most part, challenging, fun, interested, and interesting. A few years ago, when I was at the 18-year mark, I was teaching a freshman class, and it occurred to me with a shock that I had been at Queensborough longer than the group of students had been alive. In any case, just as I hope to teach them every day, I learn something from them every day as well. But best of all, I have met the most wonderful colleagues, mentors, and friends I could ever have wished for. Thank you for being part of my Queensborough life.
Alexi Kasolov.
Well, never thought when I started working here almost 23 years ago that I still gonna be here. But here I am, and I really liking it, and thanks Queensborough. It's a very nice place to work, and I'm gonna be here for a while. Thank you.
Good afternoon, everyone. I would like to thank the Engineering Technology Department for their 20-somewhat years of support, and I was to be benefit and to do so well in the Engineering Technology Department. I would also like to identify the chairs, Professor Idala, Professor Nishelsky, Professor Asser, right, Professor Hamid Namdar, and our new chair that has just been voted in just a couple of weeks ago, Professor Marvin Gale, and the support that they give me and all of the other of my colleagues.
Go, 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 go.
Throw it out.
I've always said we have the best job in the whole world. Think about it. Where else can you pursue your interests, you know, and at the same time do a lot of good and help the future of our society? Sounded less corny in my head, but it's true, and I do still believe it. So it's no surprise at all that the 20 years have gone by so quickly, and everybody's been like a family to me, and I'm hope to be here another 20 years with Bob.
Hello.
It has really been my pleasure working with the students, faculty, and staff at Queensborough for the last 21 years. I met so many nice people and made so many friends. Thank you.
Malloy. 21 years ago, I made the transition from clinical nursing practice to academia and have never looked back. It has really been wonderful. I love the classroom, I love the students, I love the faculty and the nursing department, and I feel so proud of the nursing graduates that we turn out. Thank you.
Renee Rod.
On grass. Thank you so much. Thank you, everyone. When I first found out that we were going to have 1 minute to speak, I kind of panicked. But then once I calmed down, I realized that I'm amongst friends, so I want to thank everyone for your support. I had a wonderful time. It's 20 years. I don't know if many of you know the small trivia about me. It took me 3 times to get a job here at QCC. And finally, when the third offer came in and I said yes, I immediately said to my husband, this is too quick. Nothing moves quickly in CUNY, and they're offering me this job too quickly. I'm not taking this job. Something must be wrong. And my husband said, no, this could be a good thing. You never know what might happen. And here I am 21 years later, and still going, and I enjoy my job. I enjoy the people I work with. So thank you again. I'm really having a good time. And thank you, Phil, because I met you too 20 years ago, right?
And I walked the first floor. I should thank you in your office.
Deborah Rosenwasser.
I just wanted to say thank you to Ellen Adams for hiring me 22 years ago. After spending 20 years freelancing in all kinds of industries, you guys embraced all of me for 22 years. Let me be the artist, the poet, the writer, the editor, the speaker-upper, the social justice person. Oh my God, it's like you let me just be me, and you're still letting me be me. God bless you all, and thank you.
Elizabeth Shiner.
Hello, friends and family. 25 years ago, when I started as a CUNY cap, I didn't expect that as I got my master's from Queens, I would be offered one of the first jobs as a academic advisor. The college just was opening its official academy advisement office. So I went up a few ladders, but I've stayed. I didn't expect to stay 23 more years, and it's been a wonderful ride. The people, the camaraderie, the help that we have here is unmatched. From BNG to IT, I call everybody my family, and since I retired, it's only been a few months. I miss you a lot, so I'm very happy to be here today, and thank you for the good times.
Gwen Mating.
It took me 22 years to be here. Thank you all. This is a blessing place. The more years I serve this here, the more I love this place. So guys, now I know you, why you here 30 years, 40 years, and 50 years. This is a love place. I serve with love. Love, God is love. Thank you all.
I mean, first as a student, then as a part-time lab instructor, then ultimately the coordinator of the Emergency Medical Technician Program. The opportunities that Queensborough has given me over the years, I'm so grateful for. It's a privilege to be able to help give those opportunities to all of our students, past, present, and future. So, here's to another 20 years.
Now recognize those colleagues with 30 years of service to the college. Emil Dennehy Parinello.
Thank you. Good afternoon and congratulations to all of the other honorees. Oh, it's a big reason to celebrate. In 1981, I'm going to keep this brief. In 1981, I came on campus as a freshman, and I had no idea, honestly, no idea, what Queensborough had in store for me. I didn't know that I'd be educated by such devoted, excellent professors, especially the greats in the business department. I didn't know that upon graduation, I'd be offered my first job and start my career with the greats in the data processing department. I didn't know that I would have the opportunity to work with so many of you, to develop lifelong friends among my colleagues. I didn't know that in this very building, my wife of 30 years this January, I met when leaving the building, all because I came to get an egg sandwich. So I will warn those of you who do come up for breakfast to beware of those egg sandwiches because they kind of have a habit of staying with you for a long time. But anyway, seriously, I'm grateful, honored, and privileged to be here with all of you and my colleagues. Thank you.
And Irvin Roth.
I'd like to thank Ronnie Lucas and all the incredibly great people I work with in financial aid.
My goal ever since I've came to financial aid is helping the students so they get their money, so they don't have to worry about that and they could concentrate on their classes. I do have to brag about one thing. For the last 5 years, I've totally destroyed the other colleges when it came to default rates. The college's default rate is half what the other colleges. So I'm really proud of that. Yeah, and I just want to say thank you to all of you. And again, I love working with the people in financial aid. They're very devoted. All they want to do is do everything to help the students get money. And they really work, the people in financial aid work so hard. They're just amazingly great people. Thank you.
Welcome to the podium those colleagues with 40 years of service to the college. Florence C.
Ronnie, 1 minute, and I cannot follow your 1 minute. Sorry. Well, President Mangino, Professor Pecorino, QCC faculty and staff, ladies and gentlemen, congratulations to all the honorees. You should applaud for yourself because you earned this honor yourself. And good afternoon to everybody. I am so privileged standing here to be recognized during the National Asian Heritage Month, which is May. Thank you. I joined Queensborough 42 years ago as a student and an office assistant working for a program called the Port of Entry, which was established in the same year. It is an intensive pre-college language program, and we started with 18 students sent by the Chinese government. We actually started our relation with China a long time ago when they opened the gate. And until now, it has served over 13,000 multi-ethnic students from all over the world. Thank you, and it has expanded in two sites, on Bayside campus and at a satellite branch center in downtown Flushing. I'm so grateful to this beautiful campus, Queensborough, for allowing me to provide access and achieve success to so many newcomers in this country, and also allow me to promote cross-cultural understanding through the Asian Heritage Celebration. I think we just finished last month at Queensborough. And most important of all, to nurture my career pathway all along. So thank you, Queensborough, for giving me this unusual chance. As a first-generation immigrant myself, I found my port of entry experience fulfilling and motivating. My journey here, unforgettable and impressive. And my QCC venture, rewardable and memorable, but filled with challenges and joy. This is not possible without the strong support of my dedicated port of entry team of teachers and staff. In particular, my successor, Eric Fan, and also administrative assistant, Margaret Lee. They have walked with me hand in hand through their ups and downs. And the generous scholarship donors, and all the wonderful colleagues, and some of you are sitting here, who have helped the program all along. Without them, the Port of Entry would not lived so well for over four decades. All through these 42 years,
I take pride on whatever I have accomplished, and I treasure the dear friendship from the campus and outside the campus. And most important, I enjoy to be a member of the QCC family. So thank you all for sharing this honor with me today. And finally, thank you, President Mangino, for acknowledging our contribution to Queensborough. And so is Pecorino. And to all of you, safety and wellness.
And now, please join me in welcoming to the podium our 50-year honoree who has served in so many capacities, from Director of Admissions to the Registrar, and now is Senior Director for the Office of Institutional Research, Dr. Archie Calise.
Wanted to do that. First of all, I guess thank you to everybody that I've worked with, and I'd like everybody to remember the many people that can't be here now. There was a lot of you that were here in my 50 years, and they all helped me in a lot of ways. So just a moment of silence for them, you know, department chairs, our faculty, like office staff, everybody, B&G staff. President Mangino forgot to say that I'm responsible for the student side of CUNY First. I know I want to hide with that, but we worked on that for 10 years. And we implemented a $300 million project for CUNY First. It is what it is. The same, I guess, program is used in 1,000 colleges around the country. So don't feel alone with it. It's got a lot of family. So I'd like to thank you. I'd like to thank the college. Thank you.
Everyone for attending today's event. I want to again congratulate all our honorees. Don't go anywhere. But I also want to thank our colleagues in Human Resources and Ronnie Weprin for making this happen. This is not an easy event to accomplish and to do it so beautifully. So now I'm going to ask all of our 20, 30, 40, and 50-year honorees to come up for a grand photo.